Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip.
Yeah. Thank you. is the memory of what came before.
Thank you. 15th, 2014. Dear Diary, he lives downstairs, perpetually in his dark cave, tucked away, quiet, asleep, reading, recording, I'm guessing. Every once in a while, as often as a leap year, I can visit, stay a while, make music, talk, laugh, share stories, secrets, and for a brief moment it feels normal, this brother-sister thing. But just now I'm turned away, saying that he is tired and is resting, and I fight back the tears wanting to know him, talk to him, share with him the wisdom of my experience, hear his perspective. And I'm wondering if he misses me, wants a relationship with me, or am I just a stranger that he passes by on the street? January 15th, 2014. Dear Diary. He lives down there. Down there in that foreign land, he makes beats in his lab. Intricate melodies born in a mind, genius and distant, silent and profound. Down there in that land, silent and profound. He makes beats in his lab. Intricate melodies, break beats over rhythms, born in a mind, genius and distant, silent and profound. And I wonder, I often wonder, where is the love? Doesn't he see how fragile my mother is? Cancer reeking in her body. She needs to rest, slow down, but can't. You see, she's too busy being a mother and sometimes father to my nephew, whose own mother is twisted by life and circumstance. She can't show up. She can't be there. She can't be anywhere. January 22, 2014. Dear Diary, my brother is young, absorbed only by his vision, his version of events. His son learns that sometimes he is insignificant, that making beats be doing schoolwork and projects, that sometimes my father and my brother don't listen, that my brother chooses hip-hop over fatherhood, club bangers over concerts and school recitals. And I want to blame him. I want to blame the world, blame the universe, blame my parents, blame this disease that meddles with my brother's mind, the pendulum of emotions, the highs and the lows. I want to blame him. You see, my stepfather didn't father him the way he fathered me. He offered gifts as penance for time that he could have spent, should have spent with him, you see. While he was brokering peace and building institutions of learning, in our own homes, sometimes, there were missiles in our midst. You see, my father and my brother are brilliant at what they do. Everything else is secondary unless it affects their bottom line. I love them both madly. I love my brother and I ache and I worry, and I ache and I worry and I wonder, and I want the world to embrace him and people like him, because I know that they are brilliant, because I've seen his brilliance all his life long. And I know that he will be great. I know that he will cross the stage, winning accolades for music masterfully done. And where will I be? I will be there, waiting in the wings, clapping thunderously for music masterfully done. Because I will always have my brother's back. Tenzi, Dawe Apano, Tenzi, Dawe Apano, Tenzi, Dawe Apano, Dawe Apano, Muzita Renu. Dear diary, I am sad. I am saddened sometimes when I see my mother walking on her knees with a broken back. But I am grateful that she has God, Mari. And she has good friends and good health so far in her beautiful green trees so she can breathe and release. I try and offer solutions, my thoughts deemed too emotional, maybe because I am a woman, maybe because I'm an artist. I speak, but they don't hear me. I speak, but they don't listen. I don't mean to be forceful. I don't mean to be forceful, but if it means their preservation, I am willing to start wars. I'm willing to fight wars. I am willing to take the shots wherever they come from, because I can heal when I'm dead. I can heal when I'm dead.
Thank you.